Hello everyone, you're welcome back to this YouTube channel. It's a pleasure to have you join me on today's video. Look, if you are a business administration or accounting enthusiast, or if you've been looking for opportunity around this area, I want you to move closer. I mean, move your phone or your laptop closer, because sometimes I'm going to be sharing one of the schools I'm going to be sharing, or one of the opportunities I'm going to be sharing in today's video centers around this area. Not only that, I'm also going to be looking at other courses in science, but first let's look at this opportunity in business administration or accounting. Accounting is called Contabilidade in Portuguese, and there are 17 vacancies. There are 17 opportunities that is open and international students can apply, although there is a clause. But there is a way to go about it. This particular course, I made a video about it for the first semester. The one I'm making right now is for the second semester. The same criteria, the same conditions, and I told someone that was interested to do something, and it's just one of the things I'm going to be sharing in this video, which is going to increase your chances. Now, once again, if you are seeing this video for the first time, or if you are coming to this channel for the first time, you are highly welcome. My name is Knowledge Plug, and I share opportunities around the world, graduate opportunities around the world, and in Brazil and some other countries. In today's video, I'm taking you to Universidade Federal de Rondônia. So it's a university in one of the northern parts of Brazil, and currently, there's an application that is open, which was published on the 20th of this month of May. And like I said earlier, there are 17 vacancies that is to be filled. Now, let's read it. And like, let's just can read, because of the length of the video, I may not be able to be reading it, you know, one after the, but let's just do a scan reading. And the first paragraph says, the postgraduate program in administration and accounting of the Federal University of Rondônia, Vene Campus, has published the selection process notice for master's course. Application begin on May 23rd. Today is May 28th and continue until July 28th, right? Exclusively online through the SIGA UNR system. And I'm also going to be taking you on this SIGA, because there's also another course that I'm also going to be talking about. But first, let's talk about the accounting and the administration. The master in administration and accounting aims to train professionals with skills, blah blah blah. So don't let us go too much into that. The vacancies, there are 17 vacancies that are offered in total, with up to 14 vacancies for general competitions and 3 vacancies for candidates of affirmative actions. Okay, so the registration, like I said earlier, is going to be done at the SIGA of the school. And it will be open from it has opened from 23rd of May, and it will remain open up until 28th of July. Registration is free. Isn't that good and fantastic? And the candidate must send the required document. Now, pay close attention, because this is where the secret is. Selection will be carried out in 3 stages. The first one is analysis of the AMPAT test score, which I'm thinking you may not have. But calm down, there is something that you can do: evaluation of the research proposal and analysis of the curriculum. So the first thing that they will do, they will analyze your AMPAT test score, and they will look at your research proposal and analysis of the curriculum. Now, there are some back-end information that I know about this program, and that I know about the evaluation of this course as well. The first one I said they're going to do is AMPAT tests. They're going to analyze it, and they're also going to look at your research proposal, and they will look at your curriculum. Now, out of these 3 criteria, or out of these 3 items, the most important, or the ones that has weight, is your proposal and your curriculum. So last year, for the first semester, someone wanted to apply and the person doesn't have AMPAT. So I told the person, okay, so this is what you're going to do, write to the school. So fortunately, the person also has a professional course from Nigeria. So the person has a professional course, certification rather, from Nigeria. in this line of accounting. So we wrote an email to the school. I will have loved to share the email, actually, their response, but for the purpose of confidentiality, I won't be able to, I'm constrained. So they responded that, okay, since you already have a professional certification, which is almost the same thing like AMPAD, that the person can apply, and the person applied, and the person got it. Only one Nigerian that got it from the first section, from first academic section that they did. So what I'm saying in essence is that if you have such if you have such certification, maybe around okay, let me just give you like a hint. Maybe you have a professional certification in ACA, or you have like an ICAN, or you have any other one that is in this line, you can attach it and it will be used instead of AMPAD test. AMPAD, they actually test your knowledge of English, test your general knowledge and some areas around core subject. But then what I'm trying to say is that the fact that you don't have AMPAD does not stop you from applying. And if you're also interested in writing AMPAD, although it's going to be written in Portuguese, but if there is English part, there is English section and there's other section. But if you're also interested, let me know, drop a comment, and I will let you know how to go about it. Okay, so guys, this is a fantastic opportunity for those people that has been looking for opportunity around administration and accounting. Again, there are seven vacancies and it has been on since 23rd, and it will remain open up to 28th of July. So guys, I'm wishing you best of, but I won't stop there. Let's just go to this link, which is the SIGA of the school where you can submit your application. So right now I'm on the SIGA, and like I told you, I'm also going to be sharing with you other opportunity that is currently in progress. And it's before we even go to that, let's take more look at the accounting that I'm talking about. So it says master's degree in administration and accounting. There are 17 opportunity and it's in progress. There's another one that is also coming, agree business management and sustainability. If you are also coming from this background, you can apply for this one as well. So, but it hasn't started. It's going to be open very soon, and it's going to be open like tomorrow, which is 29th, and it will remain open up till 15th day in the month of June. That is very good. So another one that is currently on now is psychology. If you are interested in psychology, guys, please try as much as possible to submit your application. There are 39 guys, 39 vacancies that need to be filled up. So if you are interested, try to give it your best shot. You need a proposal, you need CV, Lattice CV, and of course, see, there's something I need to tell you guys. When it comes to application to Brazil, do not take it for granted. Every necessary document that you need to put in place. Brazil is actually a country that all the Latin America countries, all the Latin American countries, they are looking up to. So the academic is very standard. The analysis, the assessment is not just something that you can just submit a shabby application and you'll be expecting a good response. So please, if you are going to be applying to any school in Brazil, please make sure that you give it your best shot. Every necessary document that you need to submit, please make sure that you submit every necessary instruction that they, as a matter of fact, if a school says you should upload the front and back of your document, of your certification, and maybe you are coming from a country like Nigeria where there's literally nothing at the back of your certificate, still upload both. Most of the application, if you have Canvas, you will see front and back of your certificate. So don't just say, oh, there's nothing at the back of my, there's no any sign, there's no anything inscription at the back of my certificate, let me just upload. It can also affect your application. So every necessary information, make sure that you read the editor. The editor is just like the notice that tell you all the information that you need to know about the course. For example, this psychology, the editor, you're going to see it here. If you click, you're going to see view selection process data. You are going to see all necessary information that you need to see in this part. But this page is just going to take you to the program website. Each of the program have their own site, you know. So this one is going to take you to the program, but this part is going to take you to where you can read the editor. So guys, there are two, let's just say technically there are three opportunities right now, because tomorrow this one is going to start 2017-39, guys. That is almost 70, right? That's like almost 70 opportunity. This is 50, this is 60. So what am I even saying? This is like almost 80 opportunities. Yeah, this is 30, 50, 60, you know, 70, almost 80. So guys, try as much as possible to apply to whichever one that aligns with you, with your profile. So like I said, do not let the fear of AMPAD dampen your motivation. You can put in any other document or any other certification that you have from your country of origin that is in line in that is, you know, related to this line. Okay, so guys, I'm wishing you best of luck. Don't forget, if you are coming to this channel for the first time, don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, and don't forget that information is power. When you share information with someone, you are empowering the person. If this is not your area, but you know someone that is interested in accounting or administration or psychology or in agribusiness, okay, please kindly share this information with the person, okay? And of course, posterity, we appreciate you for that. So thank you guys. Let's move to another one. So in this one, we are looking at a postgraduate program in electrical engineering, and this particular one specifically talk about conditions for foreign student. But let's look at the registration. Registration is going to take place from June, so you have time to start preparing. That is from next week. We're going to, by the grace of God, we're going to be in the month of June, so you have the opportunity to start preparing your documents. So this, the first, this one here is the announcement for the first semester. So we are talking about the second semester now. Selection process for candidates for the enrollment in the doctorate course. The first semester was actually for master, so the second semester they are calling for doctorate. So if you are interested, and you can also from master, you can also from your first degree apply to the PhD, the doctorate program, if you have a very sound qualification or sound academic history. So it says the coordination of the postgraduate program in electrical engineering at UFJF Jujufora announces to interested parties the opening of the selection process for candidates to fill vacancies in the academic master's and doctorate courses of PPEE for the second semester of the. Okay. So, I beg your pardon. This is announcement one and this is announcement two. This one is for first semester. Okay, there's another program I actually want to make a video about, and that is civil engineering, but this one is electrical engineering. So the electrical engineering is open for masters and it's also open for PhD. So the registration is going to start in June up to July 29th. And this is how I also only translated the editor. This is what they call editor, where you're going to see all the information necessary for the, you know, for your application. So I only download the editor for the doctorate course. You can see the preamble and you can see information for foreign candidate who wish to apply for the selection process, what you need to do. But even though if you don't have your visa yet, once you get your What's it called? Once you get the admission letter, that is what you're going to use for the visa processing. There are two research area or concentration where which you can focus on when you're going to be writing your what's it called, your proposal. The first one is electrical power system. The second one is electronic systems. So you can also get more information about the course here, talking about the faculty, talking about, the previous activities. So there are 14 vacancies for the doctorate alone. So at the time of the registration, the candidate must choose one of the research area. So of the total numbers for doctorate, half will be allocated to each of the concentration area. That is half for electrical power system, the half of it for electronic system. So of course, these are the quota, different quotas that they are also considering as well. So registration in the above group must be requested exclusively by candidates. So if you want to register under any of these quotas, then you have to take a step, take one more step ahead and do like a re you make a request, okay? And yeah, that's it, guys. So if you know someone that is interested in electrical engineering or it is you, please try to submit your application, try to gather your document and try to submit a very good application. Don't forget, again, don't submit shabby application. Read this editor properly. I'm going to be dropping the link in the video description box below, so try to download it. If I drop it won't appear like this because this is like a PDF that has been translated already. But I will drop the link where you can get it and you can translate it. So make sure that you digest it very well, understand the details so that it will guide you on how to submit this application. Again, I don't want you to submit a shabby application, and I'm wishing you best of luck in your pursuits. If you are coming to the channel for the first time again, please don't forget to like, don't forget to share, don't forget, of course, to subscribe to the channel. Share with someone that may be interested, and drop a comment if you want me to look at specifically about some areas. For example, I saw some opportunity in nursing, psychiatric nursing, and some other areas, but there are some conditions that I feel people that are not in Brazil might not be able to apply to. But if you're already in Brazil and you're looking for opportunity, please let me know that too. There's too much of opportunities for people that are already in Brazil, foreigners that are already in Brazil that are looking for opportunity to study. So please drop a comment. I will be swift to respond to your concern. On to the next video. Até breve. Ciao, ciao.